office in Las Vegas for like 3.5 years. I got caught up in some situations, like for example, gambling, like that. I went to talk to the bishop about getting some help of getting out the situation, and he referred me to come out here to Salt Lake City.
How often is this performed here?
Every second Sunday of the month.
You have a lot of friends here?
Absolutely.
Can you talk about your friends a little bit? What kinds of friends do you have, and how do they help you, or how do you help them?
I have friends all walks of life. Some, you know, drink a lot. Some panhandle, etc., etc. And what I do, I would give them something to look forward to. They feel calm down, say, man, things gonna be okay. And they help me to allow me to help them.
So I'm 16 years old, I ended up having my first child, who is now 11, actually 16, and she came 2 days after my birthday. I have been in and out of the drug scenery. It took a long time before I decided to get my act together and be a mom. I do have two beautiful children of my own. I have a lot of adopted kids now, and I'm a drug court graduate, a felony drug court, and dependency drug court. We have completed DCFS, which was a big challenge. This is my son, Caden, right here, who was in foster care for 10 and a half months. That was a very hard, very hard thing we went through, but we did it, and we are surviving now. We are single moms. I live in a house with single moms and six kids, and we fight every day just to see what we can do to make our kids and to stay out of the drug world, you know.
Where do you see yourself in 1 year from now on?
In 1 year, well, with a whole bunch of kids still. I don't know. Hopefully I'm going to be back in school, because I did start working.
I was down in Vegas for 4 months and couldn't get any work. And somebody told me to come up to Salt Lake, beautiful place, and they got plenty of work.
You have a place to stay?
Staying at the shelter right now.
At the shelter. How is that treating you?
It's okay. It's not bad. It's not the hotel, but it's something. It's better than nothing. Live just a lot like y'all, just without a home.
What do you see yourself in 1 year?
In a home.
In a home?
In a home.
How are you going to do that?
Continue working, continue building up. I have two kids back home, and I'd like to get them out here soon.
Can you tell us more about this gathering here, what you do, what does benefit you? Tell us a little bit more.
Well, it started with me about a year and a half ago. I started going to a church. It's called Unity. It's a non-denominational church, so we have Jewish, LDS people, Baptists, some people from the gay community, just about everything. But we come to the park here, and we do a potluck. And I usually bring chicken. I buy chicken at Smith's. You know, I spend anywhere from like, you know, $50 to $100. And it's like the cost of dinner, but people really like it. Homeless people really like it. It's kind of a treat. But I think it gives more to us than them. It makes me feel good. It makes me feel like I'm doing something, you know, giving back a little bit. Because, you know, a lot of these people are, you know, they're good people. Everybody has misconceptions about the homeless. A lot of them, you know, they have families, you know, some of them had, you know, business jobs, but they just kind of gave up on life, you know. I mean, it's a tough world out there. Some of them just gave up. So this is our chance to, you know, try to help them out and brighten up their day. We're not trying to solve the world's problems, but I think just doing a little bit helps.
How long have you been doing this?
About a year and a half. But I think the guy in charge has been doing it for like 5 years or so. It's been quite a while, you know. But the crowds keep getting bigger. That's kind of the sad thing, is that especially in the summertime, more and more homeless people, see more and more. You know, the rest of the world, I think they kind of ignore them. But they usually find their way, you know, to this park or something if they're hungry or something. It's kind of a good get together. It's good to see a smile on their face. You know, some of them have drug problems. Others just, you know, the alcoholics or something. But others just, you know, they seem like they're normal people. You know, so you get a pretty good mix of everything.
How far away is everybody in this country from being in this situation?
Probably about 2 or 3 months, I bet. You know, if you have a home, you know, Utah's like, I'm in the mortgage business. Society here in Salt Lake Valley, everybody wants, you know, to live higher up on the hill, the bigger house, but a lot of people can't afford to pay for those houses. So what happens, a lot of them go into foreclosure, they file bankruptcy, they get divorced, they lose jobs, and, you know, I mean, we're all, you know, this world's really fragile, and there's nobody out there that's immune from losing everything.